Thank you, Carlos. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to All Faiths Unitarian Congregation. My name is Michelle Gemma, as many of you know. I'm a very proud member of All Faiths. Here, you will find a very diverse and inclusive spiritual community where we welcome people with many beliefs. You can bring your whole self, your full identity, your questioning mind, and that expansive heart. At All Faiths, we have more than one way of experiencing the world and understanding the sacred. So no matter who you are, wherever you are on that spiritual journey, and no matter whom you love, you are truly welcome here. And I'm nervous for some reason today. Sorry. Is anyone here visiting for the first or second time? And if so, please raise your hand. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're so glad that you're here with us today. And if you'd like to know more about All Faiths, please see somebody in our membership corner, Fran Way or one of our greeters, or anybody that is a member. We're very proud of our congregation. So anyway, if you're interested, or if anyone else is interested, please visit our website. It's allfaithsuu.org. I have a couple of announcements, but today I'd like to ask Anna Lee Hudanik to come up first.
Good morning. Don't freeze. I'm not asking for money. I'm here to thank you. Operation Joy had a very nice shopping visit again, and a lot of little kids are going to have shoes, and a lot of little bottoms are going to be dry and sweet smelling. Now, on the shopping list that I got from the people at the outreach was one particular kind of unusual item. And we bought them. And when we got there and we handed an armful of umbrellas. Lisa, the lady in charge of the outreach, was so excited. She could barely contain her joy. It was like we had given her a bag full of money. So this proves that joy comes in many different shapes and forms. And hang on to that, because I'm going to be back in August, and then I'm going to ask for money again.
Thank you, Annalie. Thank you, Annalie. Now, may Joan Marshall come forward, please. There
you go. I'd like to invite everybody here to join us tomorrow evening, 6 o'clock. We're going to have a film screening. It's a wonderful film. It's a sequel to the film Kiss the Ground, which I know a number of you have seen. And it talks about one of the major contributors to climate change, which we don't think about much, but it's our food. The way we grow our food, the way we distribute it, and the way we throw it away into the landfills. And it talks about that industry, and it talks also about the future that we need to build with regenerative farming. So I encourage you to join us. It's extremely well done documentary, and we'll be discussing it and discussing what we can do in our lives to help fight climate change. And I hope to see you there, 6 o'clock here tomorrow night.
Thank you, Joan. Sounds great. Okay. The other announcements are on the back of your order of service, so please take those home and, as Regina says, put it on your refrigerator. Now, if you could rise in body and spirit, if you can, please sing hymn number 361, Enter, Rejoice, and Come In.
Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Oh, Open your ears to the song. Open your ears to the song. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Open your hearts, everyone. Open your hearts, everyone. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Don't be afraid of some change. Don't be afraid of some change. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Beautiful. As our chalice lighter, Ms. Donnelly, comes up to light our, thank you. We will recite the words in our order of service. At this hour, in small towns, in big cities, in single rooms or ornate sanctuaries, many of our sibling Unitarian Universalist congregations are also lighting a flame chalice. As we light our chalice today, let us remember we are part of a great community of faith. May this journey to glory inspire us to fill our lives with the universalist ideas of love, justice, and truth. Okay, now do we have children? Yes, we do. Let's join together in singing our hymn number. There is no number. Go Now in Peace. Sorry. As the children go to child care.
Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the spirit of love surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go.
I'm on. I heard that little reverb really quick. All right, it's good to be back. I missed you all last week very much. Very, very much. I'm so glad to see you all. I'm going to share a little bit, and then we're going to move right into the joys and sorrows. Okay, first thing I want to talk about is that we are working towards renewing our welcoming congregation. And in order to do that, We have special observances for the LGBTQIA plus community. And as a matter of fact, today we have a visitor with us from Visuality. He's right here in the front, sitting right next to our Rainbow Connections co-chair, Frank Stevens, and we have Matthew. What's your last name, Matthew?
McWaters
is here visiting with us. I went and visited their facility, and now today they are here visiting with us. And thank you for coming. We appreciate that. And to all of our visitors, welcome today. Another thing that I noticed in the order of service, right in the announcements, the part that you read on your own, it says something about ministers' support group. I, being the minister, have a lot of people pulling, wanting, asking questions, desiring various different things. And at times, people want to share something, they can't get to me, et cetera, et cetera. Well, I do have a small team, and they usually would be kind of like my eyes, my ears, my nose, my mouth. But they are there, and they help me to see things that maybe I missed, and maybe sometimes I'm not available to speak to someone, and you want to say something or get a message to me, or you may actually have a little gripe or complaint, and that's all normal also. So you can always speak to me, or you can speak to one of my supporters. So I'm going to ask my supporters if you would please stand up so everyone will know who you are.
Frank,
Marge DeBalbo is not here, but Marge is on the right. So we have Frank Geltner, Joyce Rame, and Marge DeGalbo. We may have some changes now because Marge is going to be stepping away from the board. But just so you will all know that They are there not only for me, but for you. So this way, we are all together and we can understand what's going on, and you have someone that you can go and talk to if I'm not available, or again, like I said, if you have something you want to complain about and you don't feel like stepping to me, because I might bite you, no. Because I may not be available, it's all right. You go and talk to one of them, they'll get the message to me. And we do have a meeting coming up this week. So if there's something and you cannot speak with me, please make sure you speak with one of them and we'll get together and we will figure it out and make things as best we can for all faith. Okay, so now let us go over here because it is time for joys and sorrows and gratitude. So if you have a joy or sorrow or gratitude, I invite you now to please come right over here and you can share into the microphone and light a candle. And I'm gonna get this ready for you. Okay, Becky, first up.
Good morning, I'm Becky Bross. And I have a joy to share with you about something that happened this week, but it's just one chapter in a story that started in the summer of 2020 when I met via Skype a young man, a Venezuelan, mid-30s, named Frank Arteaga. And I talk to Frank for an hour every week. It's my part of my nerdy Spanish practice that I do. And so you get to know someone pretty well. I've met his mother and I've met his fiance via Skype. And on November the 10th of 2022, I submitted my application to sponsor him to come to the U.S. on a two-year work program. And I got the news on Tuesday. We really thought it would never happen because a year and a half had passed, and I was approved. And within days, Frank was approved. So Frank is coming to America.
Yay,
I just have to share his whole motivation. I want to come, work for 2 years, save $20,000 so I can go back to Venezuela, buy a home, get married, and have a child.
Oh. All right, we are welcoming Frank in our hearts right now. Thank you, Becky.
I know. Well,
we have to remember, we are all immigrants. You know, no matter how much we want to turn it around, somehow or another, we made it here. Vanessa.
Hello, everyone. I would like to light a candle for Gary Latka. A few weeks ago, I went back to Broward County to attend his funeral. He passed away suddenly. Gary Latka was the founding one of the founding members of the Unitarian Universalist Church of Fort Lauderdale. And so it was sudden. Nobody knew. It was very sad. He is survived by his widow and his two adult children, in-laws, family, and friends. The second is today is the last day for me. I am leaving to go back to San Diego on Monday. Mm-hmm. I will be back October 15th. And then although I have a permanent house in Fort Lauderdale, permanent, I will be staying for good. I had a wonderful time. It was a great experience. Like I had echoed before, I'd never lived anywhere else. So when I graduated with my doctorate in San Diego, because the school was online, North Central University, it's called National University now, I decided to take that chance because I've been going back and forth to San Diego for business and pleasure mm-hmm. since the 90s. It's a wonderful place, and like I said, and I'll say it again, I don't give a damn what they say about California. It is a wonderful place, and I will visit quite often.
Right on. We are so glad that you're going to be here permanently after October, or sometime in October.
For good.
For good.
For good.
All right, okay. And we will remember Gary. Okay, Gregory.
Oh, that's okay.
That's okay, sometimes.
My name is Gregory. I wanted to share light a candle of joy this morning.
Yay.
Yesterday I celebrated my 60th birthday.
Woohoo! Yeah. Oh, yay!
Unfortunately, since moving here from Colorado 44 days ago, my dog and I had not made a single friend, furry or otherwise. But that all changed yesterday. thanks to Eddie and his dog, Bowie. Birthdays are a special day indeed.
Yeah. Happy birthday, yeah. Gregory. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Here you go. We welcome you and your dog.
Uh-oh. These candles are a little stubborn sometimes.
There you go.
Welcome, and we'll be your friends.
Yeah.
Frankie.
Good morning.
Oh.
You see three of us.
I do.
We are all together.
Speak louder, Frankie.
We're all together as a team.
It's on.
We lost one of the teams. The name is
Jeannie.
And we came together after the COVID exercise and the 10 akin. And after that happened, we came together with a team and we talked every day on the phone. Jan Guardiano would send a message to say good morning and a message to say good night. The four of us talk every day to keep each other connected. But we lost her this week.
Jeannie. He's out.
So we're lighting this candle for her family, for us, to remember her. She's a great, great member, great writer, great teacher, a great lady. Doctor.
What was her name?
PhD, yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Does anybody else want to share?
I do.
Okay.
You light, and I want to talk.
Not
only did we talk, but we texted. So we were really cool senior citizens. And I mean, I'm amazed at us, but we were pretty phenomenal. And we got Anne involved, even though she's a little bit rusty or dusty with her texting skills, but we're working on her. But Jeannie was a great contributor, and she generally sat over there with me, but she's had memory issues and was put into a retirement home, as well as her husband. But we also got to meet her grandchildren that lived nearby, so they were all part of our family, and we're not getting old, we're getting better.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I also have a joy today. My family from Atlanta, my daughter-in-law is here today for the first time. Yeah. They moved here, relocated here to be with me and to help me with the things that I'm doing. So I light this candle that they may see light in Fort Myers and enjoy Florida.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I'll light one last candle today for the joys and sorrows and gratitudes in your hearts that maybe you didn't come up and share, but you know they are there. So I'll light this candle for you that you may find peace, love, and joy in all your journeys. What do I do?
Today, we're going to do a different sound of silence in meditation. Today, we're going to be spending time in silence, amended by Stephen W. Dick. So today, we give silence its place. Our meditation will continue, include several minutes of silence. So let us pause to listen to the unheard word. Relax into a comfortable position. Breathe in and out very slowly. Quiet yourself and listen to the rhythm of your breath, your heart. Listen to the silence. You will think something, but let it pass into you and through you. You will feel something. Let it pass into you and through you. Spend some time in the unheard world. We begin to return now to the world we usually hear. As you do, try to bring something of that unheard world with you. And remember to give yourself permission to return to the unheard world. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Michelle. Now, I know that was a little different. We did something different today, and like I said earlier, it's because we are in the process of our welcoming community renewal. A day of silence. Rise up and take action. Every April, many students go through the school day without speaking, ending the day with breaking the silence rallies to bring attention to ways their schools and communities can become more inclusive. This day of silence began back in 1990s by two college students, and the day of silence has expanded to reach now hundreds of thousands of students each year. This year, 2024, they're calling it a day of no silence, because with more than 800 anti-LGBTQ plus bills introduced just last year, 2023, we must rise up and take action. The Gay, Lesbian, and Straight Education Network, known as GLSEN, has picked this day and told us this day will honor it with the day of no silence. It's recognized nationally, and it is a student-led demonstration where the community and the students, so that would be the adults and the students and all of our allies and friends around the country, even the world, protest the harmful effects of harassment and discrimination against the LGBTQ plus community, particularly in schools. We no longer want our children to suffer and to feel like they have to hide. And I can tell you, you can't do it. Mm-hmm. And when you're young and you're trying to do it, it's even more difficult. So if you know someone in the community and you see them, say hello. Greet them, invite them, especially our young people. Their lives are being threatened by these rules, regulations, and laws that are being implemented, particularly here in the state of Florida. If we don't do anything, who will be next? Could it be your hairstyle? Could it be your makeup? Could it be your entire body, ladies? All of us, we know, you give an inch, they take a yard. So let us be mindful. Don't be silent. If you see and you know they may need help, just hold a hand. Just sit beside, but never leave them alone. So this day of silence that we're recognizing, we will not be quiet today. And this is why we did that meditation. Thank you so much, Michelle. And that was, again, to honor the day of silence for our young people throughout this nation and throughout this world. And now, Spirit of Life.
Please rise in body and soul as we sing number 123, Spirit of Life.
stirrings of compassion blow in the wind, rise in the sea, move in the hand, giving life the shape of justice, roots hold me close, reeds set me free.
Now, in case you haven't realized, my name is Alberita Johnson. Most people call me Albie, and I'm the minister. That's what they call me, Albie, or Minister Albie. So feel free to, I'll come around and try and say hello to you all a little later. Our opening words for today, it's called, "We are the people of all ages." Indeed, we are. We are people of all ages who enter this space, bringing our joys and our concerns. We come together in hope. We greet each other warmly with our voices and our smiles. We come together in peace. We light the chalice to symbolize our interdependence and our unity. We come together in harmony. We share our growth and our aspirations. And we come together in wonder. We share our losses, our disappointments, our sorrows. We share our concern and our compassion. We come together in love. We come to this place bringing our doubts and our faith. We come together as seekers. We sing, we pray, and we listen. We speak, read, and dream. We think, we ponder, and we reflect. And yes, we cry and laugh, and we center. We mourn, celebrate, and meditate. We strive for justice and for mercy. We have come together this morning for all of that. So come together, my friends, my sisters, my brothers, my siblings. We have come together today to worship.
I'd like to teach the world to sing. If you know the lyrics or any part of the song, please sing along.
I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to hold it in my arms and keep it company. I'd like to see the world for once a standing hand in hand, and hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land. That's the song I hear. Let the world sing today, a song of peace that echoes on and never goes away. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to hold it in my arms and keep it company. I'd like to see the world for once and standing hand in hand, hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land. That's the song I hear. Let the world sing today, a song of peace that echoes on and never goes away. A song of peace that echoes on and never goes away.
Yeah. Love that. Our next reading is a responsive reading. Yeah. So please recite the responses printed on the order of service after each of my comments. This is called Litany of Compassion by Reverend Dennis McCarty. In the spirit of love, harmony and remembrance. We stand too often divided, too often set apart from one another in heedless ways. We seek to be compassionate, but our vision may be clouded or distracted. We too often go forward day by day and look without seeing. May we reach out in honesty and love. May we work to heal the divisions which separate Earth's children one from another. May we peer through the myths of deception which hide and deny violence, myths enclosing those who fear and suffer. May we not allow the misuse of our fellow souls to hide in broad daylight. May we reach out in honesty and love. When we see the afflicted, however they may be afflicted, it may not shrink away. May we not blame suffering on the one who suffers. May we be courageous enough to perceive suffering, compassionate enough to attend to the voices of those who suffer. May we reach out in honesty and love. When we see prejudice, when we hear evil speaking, when we witness the rough hand or the scathing word laid upon the helpless or the innocent, may we resolve to work towards unity and justice. May we reach out in honesty and love. May we turn away from the wounded head of the abused. May we not accept the twisted reasoning by which the oppressor declares himself the victim. May we reach out in honesty and love. Let our gratitude for good fortune in our lives lead us not to complacency, but to awareness. Awareness of those who live or in the shadows, are abused or neglected. May we not ignore signs of deceit or denial that hide brutality. May we reach out in honesty and love. In all things, may those who suffer ever be able to approach us, find a kindly ear and supporting hand. May we witness for love and justice at every level of relationship. May we nurture a keen eye and a strong and loving heart for any who fear the hurtful rod, the cutting voice, the uneven hand, the chain of oppression, great or small. May we reach out in honesty and love. Now, if you could rise in body and spirit and sing number 346, that would be great. Come sing a song with me.
Thank you, Michelle.
Come sing a song with me. Come sing a song with me. Come sing a song with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you home when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come sing a song with me. Come dream a dream with me that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you home when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come walk in rain with me. Come walk in rain with me. Come walk in rain with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come share a rose with me. Come. the winter time. Here's a rose for you all. Mm-hmm. May you remember to never lose hope. Mm-hmm. That's the message now. Beautiful, beautiful. And you all so nice too. All right. Time for the message. I'm on. So as you see in the bulletin or your program order of service, it says harmony. When I'm preparing what I would like to say, moving up, you know, so I start thinking, oh, maybe a month or two ahead, I'm going to talk about this on that Sunday, and what's the theme, et cetera, et cetera. Well, the theme for the month of April is interdependence. And every month, I don't know if you know this, but every month for our theme, I do at least one Sunday where I talk about the theme. So I thought, well, what's another word for interdependence? That doesn't sound so interesting. It's a big word, try to spell it. Yeah, I got it. But then I thought, well, what is that? Well, maybe harmony would be a better way of expressing it. So I wrote harmony. And then I sent it off. And that's exactly what you all have. But on the title, I really wrote United in Sweet Harmony. So if you will all just add that United in Sweet to the rest of the title. That's what I'm going to talk about today. All right, so let's get this going. Here we go. I used to think, oh, I have to put it on paper and make it in this really great big font so I can see it real good. And then I thought, we are Green Sanctuary. Why are you using all of this paper and all of this ink and electricity when you have this thing? Then I had to figure out how to use it well. You may notice me going back and forth and always the panic that comes over you, so the screen goes blank, like on Zoom or something, you can't figure out where you are, but everybody sees your face. That's one of the fears. But I got over it, and I'm using it. So please be patient if you see me looking, because technology is sometimes not as cooperative as the piece of paper. It is true. So again, United in Sweet Harmony. There is a sweetness in the sound of unity. Here comes somebody.
You're cutting out.
Oh, I don't like when that happens. Thank you. There is a sweetness in the sound of unity. And yes, I said sound of unity. And that sound is called harmony. Not unison, because that would be all of us on one, all together. But harmony, it's a sweetness to it. A sweetness and harmony, a resonance that brings a feeling of being interdependent with no shame or pretense. A beloved community, that's what I would like to picture it as. A reflection of what unity is in sweet harmony. Unity, harmony. We think, oh, well, you know, those words sound pretty closely related, but they are definitely not the same. Think of these two words, covenant, agreement. Agreement is close, but misses the weight of covenant. Today, we will explore what it means to be in unity and harmony while leaning into the sweetness of both. Questions one might consider are, who or what are we seeking to be in unity and harmony with? And can we or are we right now in unity and sweet harmony? And it got me to thinking. How many of you know the motto and the philosophy of Key West, Florida? Go ahead, raise your hand. Two people know the motto. Three people know the motto. Can I get a fourth? Okay, all right. Well,
For those of you who do not know, I'm sure you have saw it. You've seen it, it's been around, you keep seeing it, and you're thinking to yourself, well, tell me. Well, I'm gonna tell you right here. Most times, it's a sticker. We've seen it on stickers. We've seen it on bumper stickers. We've even seen it on t-shirts. And this is what it says. We are one human family. We are all one human family. I'm in Key West and I see it all over the place. Little did I know that it was their motto and philosophy, but indeed it is. Now for some people, this is a hard truth, but it cannot be denied. We are humans and tribal by nature. You know it, it's the truth. We continue to behave in societal structures that function similar to hunter-gatherers who lived within a fusion and fission. That's F-I-S-S-I-O-N. Fusion, fission, societies, a harmonious continuum in order to support the whole. So I believe for us humans to flourish as a society is to return and recognize our tribal nature operating within our societies and or groups. The question is, how do we do that? Can we go back in the past and drag it forward? You know how some traditionalists tend to think that we should live in the 5th century when we were in the 21st century. No, that's not what we're going to do. Instead, we must accept the truth of the philosophy and science. We are all one human family, although we may appear separate. But I ask you now, just look around. We are all different and yet one and the same. However, we are innately realized that there is a truth to this. We are all one human family. Do you know there are 8 billion people sharing the earth with us right now? 8 billion, that's 9 zeros. And the major majority of us would like to live in sweet harmony within and without of our groups. 8 billion people. Imagine trying to live harmoniously, just enough not to destroy the entire world with the amount of mass destruction weaponry that we have spread about the globe. And yet, deeply in our hearts, I believe we really want to be that one human family. We really want to be in beloved community. Well, we humans are sprinkled all over the world. And we look and join together and come about in various different communities, united in sweet harmony. Now for clarity, I'm just gonna go over these words really quick. Unity, the state of being united or joined as one whole. Sweet, and we're gonna talk about people here, so I'm not gonna go on about eating food. Instead, we're gonna talk about people. A person, an action that we may take. For sweet, it's pleasant, it's kind, it's thoughtful. And then harmony. We all hear harmonies. We like harmonies. But why do we like it? Because it has some sort of pleasing effect when we all blend our voices together and we appear to be in such great harmony. My voice may not be like yours, but somehow when we put them together, it makes this beautiful, pleasant sound. And it affects us. It's a pleasant effect. Unity, joined together, people together being pleasant and kind and thoughtful with one another, creating a pleasant effect harmoniously. So let's review. I'm gonna give you, today's one of our meditation days. So we're gonna have a couple little instances of it. I have to get this so I can ring the chime. So let's imagine right here, right now, you may close your eyes if you like, using your sixth sense. Not viewing ourselves individually, but sensing deeply, intuitively, that we are all one whole. One whole unit. Right now, in this place, there is unity. One whole. Now allow yourself to rest there and feel. Feel how pleasant it is to be part of something greater than yourself. Keep leaning in and experience the sweetness of that beloved community. And now one more step. Imagine, sense intuitively, that this whole sweet thing has a sound, a harmonious sound that is resounding chords of harmony and vibrating throughout your body and reverberating throughout us all. Some would say it's tribal, but it's our sweet spot, the joy, the beloved community. Now just stay there for a little while and feel it. Know you are not alone. And when you're ready, take your leave. But don't forget to tuck some of that sweetness in your pocket for later. When you're ready. This is supposed to be serious, but that didn't work so well. Anyway, it was supposed to be a big loud sound in the mic so it would startle you. So pretend to be startled. Ooh, okay. Yes, I know that startled you. It was unexpected. A sudden dissonance. A sudden dissonance. People that sing and play music, they know what that is. Well, this, my friends, is to bring us to our next point in our unity and our beloved community in sweet harmony. We can live united in sweet harmony, but there are times when our harmonious life is different. It may be a big loud chime or someone like myself trying to make a chime. It may appear not to be united or harmonious at all. In fact, it is a type of dissonance, a lack of harmony among us. Most of the time, our dissonance is not unintended because in our tribe, we merge fusion and split fission regularly, like an infinity symbol with a number 8 line on its side. We're all together, we merge, we come back and forth. We humans, we leave for school or work. This is an example. When we leave school or work, it's a fission, it's separating from the fusion of the group for a number of hours. And then when we return, we're back fused again. Or we leave our fusion to fission and return like the number 8, laying on its side, infinite. This we do as long as we are alive, in body and in spirit, maybe even in our soul and our mind. Wikipedia has a way of defining this fission-fusion society. Ethology. A fission-fusion society is one in which the size and composition of the social group changes as time passes and animals and humans move throughout the environment. So there's a little research that indicates that for species such as ours, the live-in fission-fusion societies, the group composition is dynamic, which means it has movement. The change of group and composition, that's the first one. Subgroup size, that's the second one. And then dispersion. These are the three main groups or the three main elements of a fission-fusion society. So let me give you a really good example that you can follow along. We all know that recently we had our retreat for the board. We had some board members coming and some board members leaving. We had elections and all of that. So last Friday, just passed, the composition, which is our big large group, some of them broke off to form a subgroup. This subgroup was representative of our board, the changing members. Some roles were changed while others left the subgroup and others picked up new roles. But this is in the subgroup. This is the dispersement, a dispersed group of people who are within the composition, yet moving both within and without of the subgroup, thus resulting in what appears to be a dispersion from the group. But it can also be viewed as a circle within a circle. So you know how you have a circle? And then you got to do something over here. So you might step over here, and it may appear as if you're out of the circle, but not in a fusion-fission society. Think of that circle, a united circle of beings existing together in sweet harmony, never truly leaving, instead in a constant state of returning again and again and again to the whole. Why? Because there's no leaving. We're all one human family. You're not going to leave your humanity. You keep coming back because that's who you are, what you are. There is no leaving. The Sufi poet Hafiz likens it to God climbing in your pocket and taking you along. We think that we are taking God along, but no. Think of what he said. God climbing into your pocket and taking you along. Now, I am keenly aware of our pluralistic faith, as I'm sure many of you are saying, ooh, she said God. Some believe things while others do not, and that's okay. That's what pluralism is all about. But yet, we stay together in that group. We all accept love together. So here, let us exchange that title, God, to love. And I'll tell you why. In the Christian Bible, it states in 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 through 8, really quickly, beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God. And whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. I know you know it. And since we center love in all we do, I think it is not robbery to use the term love. The poetic phrase, God will climb into your pocket and take you along, invokes a sense of divine intimacy and companionship, a fusion, if you will. So here we're going to break this down for a little more clarity, and here comes another little tiny meditation. So I'll just talk a little softer, and I won't try to ring any chimes this time. Imagine again, close your eyes, keep them open, but listen. Imagine a celestial traveler, unseen, yet profoundly present, slipping into the pocket of your heart. This traveler is none other than the divine source of all existence, the cosmic artist, the breath of life, love at its purest form. And in the quiet moments when your soul is yearning, love leans in close, with fingers gentle as morning dew, reaching into your pocket and retrieves the map of your dreams, the one you've tucked away, folded, and is fragile, those dreams of ours. Together, you embark on a journey, fission, moving from the group. Not across continents or through galaxies, but through the landscape of your own being. And love is ever present, walking beside you, and each footstep echoes in the chambers of your spirit. You are dispersing within, an inner disbursement. And along the way, you encounter valleys of doubts and peaks and joys and rivers and tears. But love is there all along with you, listening to your heartaches, collecting your laughter, and weaving them into constellations. And each star bulb is a memory shared, a cosmic breadcrumb that leads you home. Fusion. And when weariness settles like dust, love unfolds wings and nestles in that fusion. As the pocket becomes a sanctuary, a sacred space where time dissolves and eternity dances, you're back home with the composition of the group. No longer in a subgroup, traveling the galaxies, no longer dispersed, instead united in sweet harmony. And you're encouraged. You fear not, because love's presence is not confined to temples or distant heavens. Instead, it is indwelling within you. The pocket representing you is boundless. Love joins you, and together you journey toward the horizon of your soul. Infusion, infission, and disbursement, and doing it and experiencing it over and over again and again and again. So tuck this truth close in your heart. God, Goddess, the great mystery, love will climb in your pocket and take you along through sunrises and storms, across deserts and meadows. For wherever you wander, the group's love, the full composition of the group is with you, and knowledge of their support is the silent companion that you carry. So, in closing, I'm gonna make it nice and easy because this is a hard truth to talk about. Reverend Chris Boosie, a minister of the Tennessee Valley UU Church in Knoxville, Tennessee, he shares a story that I think will shine a light on the fusion-fission societies. And he uses water as an analogy. And it goes like this. It's a cute story. Once upon a time, there were two rivers flowing side by side. Both rivers liked to argue about who was best. Sounds familiar. No, I'm a R and you are a D. Who's better, Republican, Democrat, this one, that one? Well, these rivers argued. The water in my river is better than the water in your river. No, the water in my river is better than the water in your river, said the other. And the two rivers would flow along all day arguing about which river was the best. Both were quite sure they were the greatest river ever. Doesn't my water make a joyful sound as it runs over the smooth, polished pebbles on the bottom? And look at the way the sun reflects off the ripples and eddies that form around the granite boulders at my edge. These are so beautiful. Surely I am the best river, said the first river. And the other river had a reply. Ah, but look at all the fish that swim in my clear, cool water. And have you heard the frogs singing at night? They live in the reeds and lilies that grow at my banks. I am home to so many wonderful creatures. Surely I must be the best river ever. The two continued arguing until one day something strange happened. It was unexpected. Bing, like me ringing the thing. Okay. All right, it was a dissonance. A dissonance happened. Something strange. What was that? The rivers rounded a bend, slid down small falls, and suddenly saw that they were flowing towards something much bigger and greater than themselves. Uh-oh. Up ahead were two big crashing waves, and they seemed to just come into each other, and water was everywhere for as far as they can see, and they continued to rush faster and faster until the water from both rivers churned together into the vast and enormous ocean, fusion. Then a sound came from the sky. It came from a cloud that laughed for a moment and then said, now you see how foolish you've been arguing about who is the best. There is no highest or lowest. There's no greatest or least. All things are one, and all are joined together like rivers in the sea. End of the story. We are human, you see. We are spirit. We are infinite beings. Our beginnings are our endings. The circle of life always continues. From my perspective, we are a united, beloved community, coexisting in united, sweet harmony. So I ask you this morning, as I close for real, rest, beloveds. Lean on each other. Learn to trust the promise to be there for one another. We are interdependent, not independent, but interdependent. Always have been, always will be. May we never lose sight of our covenant to love. Amen and Ashe. Yeah, I know this morning, it was a hard one. United in sweet harmony, fusion, fission, knowing that we are all one human family. Although we may not always agree, does not mean we can separate ourselves from our humanity, from who we are. So, we talked about love climbing into your pocket and taking you along. So let me give you a joke right before we do the offering, because it makes us generous. Okay, remember, this is a joke. What's the difference between love and marriage? Oh, everybody's trying to figure that one out. Well, love is one long, sweet dream, and marriage is the alarm clock. There you go. It will wake you up. Yes, indeed. If you haven't been married, once you get married, you'll know what we mean by that. We appreciate your generous donations, which support our dedicated staff, beautiful facilities, inspiring services, and interesting activities here, and our social outreach at All Faiths. We invite all visitors to place their completed visitor cards in the baskets as they go by. And if you are with us live streaming, watching our service right now, you can mail your checks or visit our website, allfaithsuu.org. Our offering will now be taken and graciously received. Thank you.
Oh, why you look so sad? Tears are in your eyes. Come on and come to me now. And don't be ashamed to cry. Let me see you through, 'cause I've seen the dark side too. When the night falls on you, you don't know what to do. Nothing you confess could make me love you less. I'll stand by you. I'll stand by you. Won't let nobody hurt you. I'll stand by you. So, if you're mad, get mad. Don't hold it all inside. Come on and talk to me now. Hey there, what you got to hide? I get angry too. When I'm alone like you, when you're standing at the crossroads and don't know where to go, let me come along. 'Cause even if you're wrong, I'll stand by you. I'll stand by you. Won't let nobody hurt you. I'll stand by you. Even in your darkest hour, and I'll never desert you. I'll stand by you. When the night falls on you, you're feeling all alone, you're wandering on your own, I'll stand by you. I'll stand by you. Won't let nobody hurt you. I'll stand by you, even in your darkest hour, and I'll never desert you. I'll stand by you. I'll stand by you.
I like to teach the world to sing. I'll stand by you. Thank you, Carlos. Beautiful, beautiful. Our closing words for today. May the love that gives to life its beauty, the reverence that gives to life its sacredness, and the purposes that give to life its deep significance be strong within each of us and lead us into ever deepening relationships with all of life. Amen and Ashe.
And our closing hymn, Get Together. If you know the chorus part, come on, people now, smile on each other. Let everybody get together. Try to love one another right now. Love is but a song we sing, and fear's the way we lose. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Know the dove is on the wing and you need not know why. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Some will come and some will go, and we will surely pass. When the one who left us here returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading on the grass. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. If you heard the song I sing, you must understand. You hold the key to love and fear all in your trembling hand. One key unlocks them both, you know, and it's at your command. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. One more time. Come on, people now, smile on each other, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. When? Right now. One more time. Right now. In harmony, 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 harmony.
Thank you. Awesome, awesome, awesome. We want to thank Alberita Johnson for her lovely message, as always. We want to thank Carlos Garcia for the amazing music and everyone that contributes to this wonderful, wonderful service. It's great to be with you and always great to be wherever we are. Anyway, Donna Lee, could you come up and extinguish the chalice for us? Mm-hmm. Thank you, my dear. And as she comes up, we will cite the words in the order of the service. We extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts and out into the world. Thank you. Have a good rest of your Sunday. Please have some dessert, coffee, cookies, and enjoy love and harmony. Bye, y'all.